Here is one of San Francisco's many Red Cross disaster units manned by a crack rescue squad. Not the least important member is Buddy, dog mascot and valued worker. Carefully trained by his Red Cross friends, Buddy is a first-rate sleuth in picking up the trail to trouble. He discovers a victim, and he knows just what to do. His husky barks bring the rescue squad to the scene. Here is a smooth working team. Every man thoroughly practiced in first aid, ready for any disaster problem. No lost motion here. Between calls, Buddy jumps fences to keep informed. His ambition is to become a fireman, and he does pretty well in practice, too. You're a credit to the Red Cross, Buddy. Camera fans jam one of New York's most famous hotel ballrooms. What's all the shooting for? The Red Cross National Photo Award. Red Cross needed many pictures to portray its various types of war work. So the Photographic Society of America set the stage and donated United States War Savings Bonds as prizes. And both amateur and professional cameramen come out in droves to help Red Cross get its pictures. And maybe win an award, too. The fans have a field day and try to make every shot a winner. Some use the opportunity to put real messages through the Red Cross Inquiry Service that has helped thousands of anxious families to get in touch with relatives in occupied countries. Leave it to these lads to get the situation well in hand. And here are just a few of the entries. Thank you, camera fans, for your fine help. Fort Hancock, New York. A mobile blood donor unit drives into this famous Coast Artillery post for an impressive event. Personnel of an entire company has volunteered to give their blood to the Red Cross in honor of the memory of a comrade, Private Michael B. Hartery, a buddy who died in service. What more fitting tribute than this? Their blood in his name to help save lives of other fighting men at the front. The captain leads his men into action. One by one, they present arms. Their blood and yours is needed. The Army and Navy are asking for 4 million blood donations this year. The Red Cross must meet the demand. Bowling fans from coast to coast have lined up to help the Red Cross. The Bowlers Victory Legion inaugurated tournaments to help raise part of the Red Cross war funds needed for services here and along the far-flung battlefront. And to start the ball rolling, here is Genio Xavier Cugat, famous orchestra leader, who is a superb orchestra leader. Lovely Lucille Norman, MGM starlet, does better. Or did the cameraman do this? Billy Jurgis, Giants baseball star, rolls one for the Red Cross. Bowlers from coast to coast set them up for the war fund. Experiments are underway in something new in Red Cross rescue work. This unit is known as the Mounted Corps Auxiliary of the San Francisco Red Cross Motor Corps. Forest fires, floods, and other disasters sometimes claim victims in remote places, inaccessible to motor units. Experimenting to solve this problem, this unit rides single file into heavily wooded areas. Their emergency rations and relief supplies strapped in saddlebags. An Indian drag, fashioned from two poles, is set up to carry the victim out of the danger zone. Here is another type of horse carriage. A stoke stretcher that will get the injured man safely to the motor unit, waiting below at the fringe of the forest. May someday save many lives. And these riders will be ready when the call comes. A salute to the WWII, our gallant ladies in olive drab. At Daytona Beach, Florida, 50 Women's Army Auxiliary Corps officers are being put through an intensive two-week period of training by expert Red Cross instructors on life-saving and water safety. Each will qualify eventually as an instructor in her own right. Practice makes perfect in rhythm necessary for artificial respiration. The WWII welcome the waterworks. A neat trick. Barracks bags turn into life preservers on a moment's notice. The Red Cross gives them a tough course, even swimming through fire. But don't you try it unless you know how. Red Cross class over, these WWII can now brave the waves. Somewhere on the Long Island coast, and what a day they picked for this test. The United States Coast Guard Auxiliary Flotilla, working with the Central Queens Red Cross, is staging an evacuation drill. Supposedly, a bridge has been bombed, marooning 50 islanders. The Coast Guard goes to the rescue. The water is frigid, but the air is 10 below zero, so the waves seem steaming hot. Aided by the Red Cross, the victims are picked up and brought to the Coast Guard station. Here, other Red Cross units have arrived to give help, and is it cold? Casualties are taken care of. Severe cases are brought to ambulances. The Red Cross mobile canteen unit works overtime, and does that hot coffee kill the chill? Mmm.